بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. It was narrated that our mother Aisha رضي الله عنها, may Allah be pleased with her, she asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, I see you fast of this month of Sha'ban more than anyone apart from Ramadan. She says the Prophet ﷺ used to fast a lot of Sha'ban. Sometimes he says he would fast most of it. Why you do that, especially Sha'ban? So the Prophet ﷺ answers by saying, this is a month that falls between Rajab and Ramadan. And Rajab is a holy month, is one of the sacred months, Rajab. This month, which is now is the end of it. And Ramadan is the very special month of Quran revelation. Sha'ban falls in between where people don't pay much of attention to it. It's the doorstep of Ramadan. Sha'ban is the beginning of Ramadan. Sha'ban is to receive Ramadan, is preparation for Ramadan. People don't pay much of attention. It's just like the sunnah before salah. So when you come to salatul dhuhr, there is two or four rak'ahs you make before dhuhr, right? Likewise for fajr, right? So for Ramadan is the fard. So before that fard, you prepare it with some sunnah, which is the fasting in Sha'ban. Likewise, after Ramadan, the sunnah of fasting after Ramadan is just like the sunnah after Dhuhr or Isha, correct? Or Maghrib, correct? So the Prophet ﷺ said to fast few days of Shawwal, the month after Ramadan, just like we do with the Salah. This is how you prepare for this very special month. Ramadan is definitely the very special month of the whole year. It's the best or the most important months of the year, because it is the month of the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, and the Quran is the best that was revealed to you from your Lord. إخواني, my brothers and sisters, the Quran is very important and very special, and everything associated with Al Quran is very special. The month that was the month where the Quran was revealed is very special. It's the month of Ramadan. The night which witnessed the revelation of the Ramadan of the Quran, which is the night of Qadr, Laylatul Qadr, is the best night ever in the history or in the year, because it happens every year, right? Laylatul Qadr. People who take care of the Quran, Ahlul Quran, people who carry the Quran, carry the Quran physically and meaning and applying, Ahlul Quran, as the Prophet ﷺ said, hum ahlullah wa khassatuh. They are very special. They are the special people with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the chosen ones. And the Prophet ﷺ said, khayrukum, the best of you, man ta'allama al-Qur'ana wa 'allamah, is the one who learns the Quran and teaches the Quran. So anything associated with the Quran is in the top, is very special. And this is what Ramadan is. It's the month of the Quran. So you prepare yourself before Ramadan, just like you prepare yourself for Salatul Dhuhr. Salatul Dhuhr is the very special Salah as Muslims. Salatul Dhuhr. It's the midday Salah, midday. You stop everything and you make your Salah. So you prepare for it, because you know in the day there's a lot of noise, right? There's a lot of things happening in the marketplace, at work, and so on. So you need to bring yourself some peace. So before you get yourself into the salah, the fard, you make some sunnah. You prepare it with two or four rak'ahs, so you can get yourself in the mode of salah. You prepare yourself to make your faridah by making the sunnah. That's like that with Ramadan. The good people, used to prepare for Ramadan in Sha'ban by fasting some days of Sha'ban. 3 days of the month, 2 days a week, anytime, any days you like. Also, they would prepare for Ramadan by reciting the Quran, starting giving more attention to the Quran in Sha'ban. So in Ramadan, they would have a set schedule for the Quran, because this is the month of the Quran. Ramadan is the شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. It's the month where the Quran was revealed as a guidance to the humanity. Subhanallah, ikhwanna, my brothers, yani people celebrate occasions that are way, way less than the revelation of the Quran. The Quran is the most important event in the history of mankind. Quran revelation to humanity is the most important event in our history as mankind. So it deserves to be celebrated. And Allah said so. It's the month of Ramadan. And Laylatul Qadr is witnessed first by the angels of the heaven, by angels. تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا. The angels would be ascended, headed by the archangel Jibreel in the night of Qadr. See, Jibreel is no longer comes to earth after the death of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he said that he gave farewell to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the final revelation of last verse. And he said, oh Muhammad, this is my last visit to earth, and I have no other work or business on earth after you. Because Jibreel is the angel of revelation. So he would no longer come down because there is no more prophethood, no more revelation. But in the day of, or the night of Laylatul Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا. The angels will come down, will ascend or will descend down to earth with the archangels is amongst them. But this time he comes as part of the celebration, celebrating or marking this night of the Quran. So Jibreel comes then. This is very special. So we prepare by taking care of the Quran and start by reciting and studying the Quran or preparing ourselves for that. The third thing we do is preparing ourselves with the sadaqah, because Ramadan is the month of sadaqat, of giving. It's truly the month of giving. We fast, we abstain to give. Not to torture our body, not to get healthier. It's because Allah said fast. Although we will get healthier, although we will get a lot of virtues and benefits, but this is not the reason. The reason is Allah said to fast. And if you fast, you have very special gate in paradise dedicated for those who fast fi sabilillah, seeking the pleasure from Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said there are 8 gates of paradise, right? 8 gates, right? 8 doors. Al-Jannah has 8 gates. Hellfire has more or less. Hellfire has 7 gates. So as a mercy of Allah, there are more gates, more doors of paradise. So if all the people would enter paradise, there is room for them. In fact, there is room for everybody. But unfortunately, there are some people who regretfully will not get into it. So there are more gates, and there is one special gate of them called Ar-Rayyan. And this is special for those who fast. Those believers, there is a gate called Ar-Rayyan. They will enter from that gate if they want. You know what? Once the Prophet ﷺ was asked, Ya Rasulullah, could people be called from different gates of paradise? He said, yes, because some people may be called from the gate of Ar-Rayyan, some people will be called from the gate of giving, of sadaqah, the gate of jihad, different types of jihad, the gate of sacrifice, the gates of paradise. There are allocations, right? Although each gate is very huge. So one person whom you know, He said, Ya Rasulullah, could somebody be called from all the gates? His name, like people will say, come from here. You know, have you seen these beautiful seas in the kingdom in Ramadan where you are traveling and you stop in the checkpoint and start 3-5 people want to take you for iftar? Or you are in the Medina, in Medina al-Munawwara, and there are 3, 5, 10, 20 families making iftar. Everyone wants to hijack. He wants to abduct you. They want to take you. Come, you have to breakfast with me. Yes, at that time, there will be people whose names will be called from all the gates. But unfortunately, some people will not find their names anyway. But he said, would somebody be called from all the gates? He said, yes, and I hope you will be one of them. Who was that? Who was that? It was Abu Bakr. It was Abu Bakr. I hope your name will be called from all the gates, Abu Bakr. So some of you will definitely be called from all the gates, inshallah. So by giving sadaqah, giving charity now, giving help, and you know what? There are a lot of need for sadaqah, financial and other types of sadaqah. So this is how we prepare for Ramadan. And you know the least preparation people could make is to stuff food items. And this is definitely not part of the preparation of Ramadan. Not recommended at all, because it will cause a lot of problems to the market too. So this has never been part of preparing for Ramadan. Actually, Ramadan is to consume less and to give more, not to consume more. So it's not part of preparation of Ramadan. Yes, no problem to buy some good items for yourself and the family. Is of course, bring to your family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لِيُنْفِقْ ذُو سَعَةٍ مِّن سَعَةٍ. You should spend of what Allah gave you, but don't go lavish. Don't go extravagant. Don't waste. And be moderate. And think of those of others. You can only, you only need a little bit to survive. Think of others who have much less and they don't have. Preparing for Ramadan is definitely as preparing for the Salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us this great opportunity now to prepare for Ramadan, and also people to prepare to pay their zakah. To conclude with that, zakah is a mandatory, brothers and sisters. Zakah is something that we have to pay. Allah gave you money plus, so you can pay this extra to the needy. So we need to give it. We need to spend it in the right cause. This is zakah and more. So those who do not spend the zakah, they should think now of start giving it, especially now when Muslims are in need, when people are in need. And you know what? Start with your closest circle, your family, your own family, immediate dependent. You cannot spend zakah on them. You have to spend from your core, hardcore money. But your relatives, your neighbors, your surroundings is where your zakah starts. You start by giving your zakah and sadaqah to your close circles, closest then to the farthest. And we should do that. We should show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of what He gave us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the straight path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the chance to reach Ramadan, to fast Ramadan, to do the best in Ramadan. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah bring peace to this land and to Syria and to Palestine and to Yemen and to every part of the world. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.